What's going on, Wealth Giants? Ryan here. Today we're going to be talking about FIFO versus LIFO. What is it and how can it help you become a better investor and save some money actually? But first, if you are new to the channel and are interested in wealth building strategies such as stock market investing, please consider subscribing to the channel, smash that like button if you find value in this video, and leave a comment down below if you have any questions. So let's go ahead and get right into this. Now first, what is FIFO and LIFO? So FIFO is first in, first out. LIFO is last in, first out. Now you probably heard this in retail. You know, that just means like the first product that comes in is the first product you sell typically. Now, what does this have to do with stocks? All right. So stocks, when you sell them, you're not selling just random stocks. It's like, oh, I have 10 of them. I'm going to sell, five of them and it's just going to be at random. No, it doesn't work that way. You are selling specific shares. All right. So typically it follows FIFO or LIFO, and typically it is an automatic FIFO, but you can also change it to LIFO, and I recommend looking into which one it is at whichever point you decide to sell some stocks to diversify or just cash in some profits. Real quick, why am I talking about FIFO and LIFO anyway when there's thousands of things I could be talking about when it comes to the stock market? So it actually has something to do with my portfolio. My portfolio has become very vulnerable lately, mostly due to one position of mine that has outshined all my other positions, and that would be Tesla. For those of you who have been following Tesla know that it's been going up and up and up and up. And it's not a bad thing for me, but it's a bad thing for the diversification of my portfolio. My portfolio started out with 32% of it being in Tesla. Now Tesla consumes over 58% of my portfolio, which means that I am vulnerable in case Tesla decides to decrease in value, which makes me think, should I sell a few shares or not? Which leads me to the question of, should I use FIFO or LIFO? Now, real quick, with a shout out to the portfolio, I actually hit my February goal of reaching five figures. We are actually approximating $12,000 in the portfolio. We had our first four-figure shift day, so it gained $1,000 in a day. It did it 2 days in a row, and then followed by a $1,300 decrease. But that's okay. I mean, it just helps me become more immune to the waves and the volatility of the stock market. So I'm okay with it. Anyways, let's go back to what I was talking about. All right, so I'm going to go ahead and just jump right into an example with you guys, and that'll explain when you would use FIFO, and then I'll do one of when you would use LIFO. Keep in mind that this is for short-term, or long-term investments in the same company. I don't want to mix the two up just yet. I will go into that last. So let's go ahead and look at this. So you have a company you're looking into and you're really interested. Let's call it ABC. And you say, I want to buy into this. You buy one share for $100. And then for some reason, it just plummets down to $50 a share. Well, you wanted to lower your cost basis, so you buy one more share. So you have two now, one at $100 and one at $50. Well, then for some miraculous reason, it shoots up to $150 a share. Well, you decide, I want to cash in a little bit. I want to diversify a little bit. So I'm going to sell one of those shares. Well, which one do you sell? Because you got two. And you bought them at different times at different prices. So you want to look at how much you're going to gain in capital gains. For the first one that you bought it at $100 and you're selling it for $150. So it would be a $50 gain. Whereas the other one, if you were to sell it, it would be a $100 gain because you're selling it for $150 and you bought it for $50, so $100. When you're paying taxes on it, you're going to either be paying taxes on $50 or $100. You would pay less taxes on the 50 than you would the 100. So at this point, you would use the FIFO method, which is the first share that you bought is going to be the first share you sell. So LIFO, a little different, but it's just the reverse of the last example. Okay, so you bought a share for $50, and then you bought a share for $100, and then it shoots up to $150, and you want to sell one of them to diversify or cash in some gains. Well, at this point, you would want to use the LIFO method, because if you were to sell the first share first, you would make $100 gains that you would have to pay taxes on. Whereas the second share you bought, you would only have to pay taxes on $50. So it would be the LIFO method of last in, first out. All right, guys. So now that we've talked about short-term, and long-term investments and which method you would use, FIFO or LIFO. Let's go ahead and talk about short-term and long-term mixed together. Keep in mind that short-term investing, you are paying according to your tax bracket, and long-term investing, you are paying a percentage based on how much you make, but it's a lot less than if you were to pay short-term capital gains. So me personally, I have 2 long-term shares in Tesla, and I have 6 short-term shares in Tesla, which means that they are going to be taxed differently if I sell them all at the same time. But I don't want to sell them all at the same time. I want to sell specific ones so I pay the least amount in taxes so I could get my money, my initial investment from Tesla, back in my pocket without having to pay too much to the government. And because of this, I got to be very careful at which ones I decide to sell. Now, most likely I will go with the long-term shares just because I pay less in taxes if I were to do that. But it's different for everyone on which ones you would want to sell. You also have to take into consideration the price. So with this, I do have a link down in the description below that goes to Nerd Wallets. It actually shows you a bunch of tax information and actually has a calculator that looks like this. It allows you to enter in your filing status, how much your annual income is, whether or not you're selling short term or long term, and it'll calculate how much you would have to pay in taxes to help you determine whether you should use the FIFO or the LIFO method. The main thing that you need to focus on is when you're using these methods, you want to be able to determine which one you are paying less in taxes so that you don't have to send all your money to the government. You know, as much as they would love to have it, I'm sure you want to keep it in your own pocket. So that's what I got for you guys today. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, smash that like button. And if you haven't already, subscribe by hitting that ugly mug over to my right. It looks just like this one. And I will see you guys in the next video.